Hey everybody, and welcome back to another episode of 7-Minute AE Tutorials, where you learn tips, tricks, and shortcuts in 7 minutes or less. No BS, just AE. And actually, that's not completely true for this episode. This episode will be a little longer than usual. We'll call it a double episode. And the reason why is because I want to talk about layer styles today. And that topic is just way too broad to fit into one 7-minute tutorial. I considered showing you how to make a specific look, but really, I think you'll get more out of this lesson if it's comprehensive. So, stick around for about 15 minutes or so, and you'll learn some really cool stuff. In this lesson, I'm going to show you how to use layer styles with text layers in After Effects. Layer styles add, for lack of a better word, a lot of style to your layers. Using layer styles with text makes your text pop and creates a more professional look than text can do alone. Layer styles can also be applied to shape layers, but we're going to focus on text in this lesson. There's a lot to get through, so let's dive right in. Layer styles are going to affect text layers in different ways, depending on the kind of font you're using, the weight of your font, and how big your text layer is. So I'm going to provide the font that I'm using, which is Gotham Narrow, and the project file that goes along with this course. And I'll also be giving you exact color settings, so that way you can follow along exactly with what I'm doing. Control or Command T to bring up your text tool. And I'm just going to type 7-minute AE tutorials. I'm going to go to layer, transform, center anchor point in layer content. And we'll see that puts our anchor point right in the middle of our text layer. Open up the align panel and let's just center this to our composition here. This is the color of my text and I'm using a black outline that's 6 pixels wide and I'm choosing fill over stroke. The font I'm using is Gotham Narrow Black and that font will be in the project files for this project. Now let's open up our text layer. So the way you add layer styles, if you go up to your menu bar layer, you'll see layer styles and there are a few ways you can add these. You can add them individually, one at a time. Or if you know which ones you want specifically, you can add only those. Choose Show All. It adds all of the layer styles. However, they're all hidden. If you go back up to Layer Styles, you'll see that there's also this option for Remove All, and that will take away every layer style. Otherwise, you can just delete them one at a time. You can take those out, and I'm just hitting Delete after highlighting whichever layer style I don't want. We're going to go over each one of these layer styles, so I'm going to go back to Show All, so that way they're all in here. Okay, so if you've used Photoshop, a lot of the settings that you'll see in layer styles are going to look very familiar. Now, out of the gate, the first thing you see are these blending options here. We have our global light angle and altitude. You can adjust this. These will affect all of your layer styles as one unit. You also have these advanced blending options. We're not going to go over these, but just so you're aware, you do have some other options. Let me zoom in here a little bit. So this is our drop shadow effect. You also have a drop shadow through the effect panel. So if we go up here and add a drop shadow. Now, if you open up our drop shadow and layer styles, you'll see that you have more options with layer styles than you do with the effect for drop shadow. So I'm just going to take away the effect and focus on our drop shadow through layer styles. All layer styles have a blend mode. So if you click on multiply, you'll see that you can change this to any number of blend modes that you want. We're going to leave this at multiply, and I'm just going to make a few changes here. So I'm going to make my opacity 65. I'm going to change our angle to 150. Let's make our distance 25, leave spread alone, and then make our size 25. So this is our drop shadow. If you can toggle it off and on, you can kind of see what the difference is. And take note of the other options you have. For example, you have angle, and this just moves your shadow around depending on where you want it to fall. We set ours to 150. You can also increase your spread, and it has a different effect. I'm going to leave this at 0. And you also have this option for noise. So if you turn it up and zoom in here really tight, you can see this is what noise does. So let's go down to our next layer style, which is inner shadow. And you can see it just creates this inner shadow inside of your text layer. I'm going to turn this up so you can really see the effect that it's having. I'm going to make some changes. Again, our inner shadow is set to a blend mode of multiply. I'm going to leave it at that. Color, I'm going to leave it black. We're going to leave opacity at 75. Angle is going to be 180. Size, we'll make 10. Distance, let's make 2. Actually, let's increase this a little bit more. So we'll make our distance 2 and our size 35. You also have this noise option, just like you did in the drop shadow. And you can see the effect that that's having. So we don't want noise for this. And then you have this choke option. So it just gives you a little bit of a different look. We're going to leave that at 0. Let's move on down to Outer Glow. And you can see just by clicking it on, it already has an effect. Let's open that up. And again, first thing we see is our blend mode. It's set to screen, whereas the first two were set to multiply. You also have this option for opacity. You can make it 100% all the way down to zero. I'm going to leave this at 75. Again, we have this option for noise. So you can increase the noise on this if you like. Then we have for color type, we have single color or gradient. So let me just change this white to something else. So like this blue. So you can either have something like that, or if you want to create a gradient, and you have this option for edit gradient. And let's just make something that will kind of stand out. We'll make our white red. Make our black, you know, something like a green. So you can see this gradient that is creating. So let's go back to color type. Okay, so let's change our single color back to white. And then I'm going to leave my size at 5, make this range 40. And we're just going to leave jitter at 0%. And we want our technique to remain softer. You have softer or precise. As you can see, it does have a difference. Okay, let's move on down to inner glow. So let's just click that on and you can see the effect that that's having. So now if we open this up, we see our blend mode is set to screen. Opacity is 75%. And again, you can tweak with that. It also has this option for single color or gradient. So we're going to leave that at single color. For technique, we have softer or precise. So I'm going to leave mine at softer. And for source, we have edge or center. And this is the difference. Say if we went with center, we can affect the size. You can see the effect that this is having. Put ours back to edge. We're going to have our size set at 7. Range, we'll leave at 50, and jitter also at 0%. Okay, so let's go down to bevel and emboss. Okay, so like as soon as we click it on, we can see there's a difference. So let's open that up, and we have quite a few options for bevel and emboss. So for style, you can see there are 5 different options. I'm going to increase the size of our bevel so that way you can see this better. That already makes our text look a lot different, and all I did was increase the size. We'll set this to 20. These are the different options for style. This is your outer bevel. As you can see, it puts a bevel around your text. It defaults to inner bevel. This is emboss. This is our pillow emboss. And this is our stroke emboss. These all have very unique looks. I'm going to leave mine at inner bevel. And then our next option for technique is either smooth. That's chisel hard. And that's chisel soft. If we decrease this down to maybe a size of 10, you can see a different style of bevel and emboss. I'm going to leave mine at smooth. Okay, and then we also have this option for direction, up or down. Just kind of moves your bevel and emboss to a different part of your text. So let's leave ours at up. For size, I'm going to make this actually a size of 12. I'm going to leave soften on. We'll leave our angle and altitude alone, but this is what those do. So as you rotate your angle around, it just kind of moves the bevel around on the edges of your text. And for altitude, and as you can see, there is a point of diminishing return. Once you get too high, it disappears. So we're going to leave this where it was at 30. Now we have this highlight mode is set to screen by default. If you change it to something like multiply, you can see this a much different look, overlay, or maybe a hard light. So these all affect your text in different ways. We're going to leave it at screen. Now our highlight color defaults to white, and that's really the best way to kind of see the effect. Once you change it to black, we can't really see the emboss anymore. So leave that at white. The shadow mode is set to multiply, and our shadow color is set to black, and you can see it gives it that depth. So you're gonna leave this at black, and our shadow opacity defaults at 75%, but you can make it darker or lighter. Now let's open up this next option for satin. It looks like it just makes it darker, but really there's a lot more going on. So for satin, this defaults to the blend mode of multiply, color defaults to black, opacity to 50%. So I'm going to lower this down to 35%. Let's go down to distance. It defaults to a value of 11. So if you adjust your distance and your size, so I'm going to make mine 40 and 35, and you can see the difference that this is having. If you kind of just scroll through this, you can really see the different looks that you can get. So set this to 40 and 35. And now I skipped over angle because I wanted to show you that you can set a script such as time to this angle and watch what it does. So you can kind of have this effect just by moving your angle around. Angle defaults to a value of 19 degrees. And then we have this option for invert. And this is the effect of enabling your invert. We're just going to leave that on. Okay, so our next layer style is color overlay. And let's click that on. And let's open it up and we see that it defaults to this red. Make this something more, maybe like a teal green. And then let's change our blend mode to overlay. And you can see the difference just by changing that blend mode, what it has on your text layer. So if we kind of go through all these, you'll see that it does have a different effect depending on which blend mode you choose. I'm going to choose overlay. And then let's set our opacity down to 30%. Basically, we just kind of darkened our text slightly. Okay, so this next option for gradient overlay is one of those that has quite an effect on your text layer. So let's click that on. And you can see that it just adds a gradient over your text. Okay, so the blend mode right now is set to normal. And we have opacity. You can actually lower this to kind of get a different look. You can edit your colors if you'd like. You can choose where you want the gradient to be smooth or hard. You can move your gradient around by adjusting the angle. Okay, and now style gives these all a very unique look. So this is linear. This is radial. We have angle, reflected, and diamond. And so if you adjust some of these settings, they all have very, very unique looks to them. So just play around with some of these settings to kind of see what all you can get out of this. I'm going to set this back to the default settings, and I'm just going to make some changes here. So with blend mode, first I'm going to make this an overlay blend mode. For style, I want to change this to reflected, and then we can leave our opacity right where it is. So this is the difference with gradient overlay off and on. So our last setting here is stroke. Now remember, we added a stroke to our text, the 6-pixel black stroke. So this option basically allows you to have a second stroke. If we open that up, we can see it defaults to red. Blend mode is normal. Size defaults to 3 at 100% opacity. And you have these options for outside, inside, and center. What we're going to do is change our color to white, set our size to 1, and then set our position to center. And so this is the look that we've created here. You can do some more adjusting with this. So just play around with some of these settings. And to see the difference in these, let's close this up. And now watch, if I just uncheck layer styles, you can see that there is a profound difference in the way my original text looks. Matter of fact, let's duplicate this, Control D or Command D. And then I'm going to take off this layer styles and let's just compare these side by side. So you have a much better idea of what we did, just adding in a few layer styles to our text to give it more depth and to have it look more polished and professional. Layer styles add a lot of flair and polish to text. Remember, how layer styles look depends on the type of font you're using, the weight of your font, and the size of your font. Experiment with layer styles and practice using them in a number of ways. You can use all of them together, some of them in different combinations, or just one of them. It all depends on the look that you're going for. I hope this helped you out. Please comment, like, share, and subscribe. I put a link to the project file in the description below, and I'd love to get your feedback about this course and any other topic you'd like to see covered. In other news, my first Udemy course, The Power of Shape Layers, is finally here. As we speak, it is being reviewed by the good people over at Udemy, and as soon as that approval has come through, I'll be putting up a promo for that course as well as a link for you to sign up to take it. I would love to see all of my subscribers on this channel take The Power of Shape Layers. There will be no question whatsoever about how to use, incorporate, and create shape layers once you complete this course. As always, thank you so much for the support. Thanks for watching, everybody, and I'll see you next time.